All right, what we're gonna do is a 16th ounce number 4 sickle hook, the bluebird jig head from Patriot Baits. We'll make something kind of flashy with this one. I think. Really wish I had some blue thread for it. We're gonna try white. Let's see how that works for us. I think if this turns out the way I picture it's going to turn out, this should be a pretty good jig. Sometimes what I picture and sometimes what I get, two different things. And we're going to give it a try here and see. We're going to do that. Blue head. Then we're going to do a white sparkly tail. I'll put a little extra flash in it. Then we're going to do a blue Chanel body. Let's see how this turns out. I'm just trying to get that body material to all twist in the same direction. But make it to where it evened out along the shank of that hook, and I think we got it. It don't look like it like that, but it should all stand out pretty straight when we're done with it. I got one piece right there, it's being stubborn. I think I got it. Honestly, sometimes it helps having that camera because I can see the backside of it. Kind of helps me out a little bit. So let's do some flashiness. Let's do this flash right here. This is the way this material comes. It comes with a zip tie. Comes like that. And what I do is I reach down here and I try to find a strand that's loose. It's easy to get to. We're going to do two of these jigs. So I'm going to pull out two strands like that and cut them off right up at the zip tie. And that material, I got off Amazon, but I can't remember what it's called on Amazon. But I'm pretty sure I looked up some kind of jig time flash. If you look it up on Amazon, it'll give you 50 million things of what you're looking for and 50 million things of what you're not looking for. So you just kind of got to scroll through it till you find what you're looking for. That stuff, the rubber tails, these rubber tails I got from Bass Pro, but I got a lot of other ones through Amazon, and they were good. There was no problems with them. The only thing I ever had problems with getting through Amazon was the Chanel, and this came from the Plateau Fly Shop in Springfield. And he has closed his doors for now because of the COVID-19. But he said he's probably going to start doing mail orders. So I'm going to put together everything I need and see if I can't come up with an order. The bad thing about doing an order like that, most of Chanel comes in a bag. It comes in a bag like that. And what I have done is I have thrown away most of those bags, so I don't know the name of it. And what I'm going to try to do is screenshot a picture of what I'm looking for and see if he can match it. COVID-19 got it all screwed up. Be so glad when it returns back to normal. Worst place I've been into so far about it is AutoZone. Stand behind the line. They gave me their tester. They had me go out and test. Check engine light on my truck. And it was, I don't know, just kind of strange. I know everybody's got to take precautions, but you know, the way they done it, it wasn't, I don't know. I mean, I guess you got to do what you got to do, but and that's that one. I come out pretty good. We're going to do two of them just like that. I think the guy that's using these lives here in Bolivar, and I think he's looking for stuff for white bass, and I'm, well, it's on the floor now. Pretty sure throwing that in a school of feeding white bass, gonna get you something. Let's tap one more like, yep. But yes, I would be so glad when it returns back to normal. Everything's a headache, even work's a headache. Bleaching stuff down all night, I come home smelling like bleach. But, you know, it's keeping everybody safe. I hope. Maybe one day we'll all look back on this and think, what a waste. But then on the other hand, too, you know, I'm scared we're going to look back on it 2 months from now and think, man, we should have done more. But you really don't know how to take it. You know, one news channel tells you one thing, one tells you something else. The CDC's website tells you something totally different. You know, so it's almost like they kind of leave you to put together what's going on. But I sure hope any one of those things we look back on and think, man, we should have done that. We should have taken it a lot more serious, but I guess time will tell. Tail here straightened out. It's all kind of wanting to stay on one side of it. Got her down pretty good. Let's do our flash. One thing I can't stand is like tying one jig and just having that one and only jig. When I, like, if I go to the store and I buy jigs, I buy two. Because you never know if that's, like, the best jig you'll ever use and you hang it up, you lose it in a treetop, and you don't have that jig no more. So to solve that problem, I always bought my stuff two at a time. You know, when I bass fish, I don't buy just one. If I'm after a crankbait or a spinnerbait, I don't buy just one, I buy two. Always got a backup. I really don't know why I glued that down like that. And I, now after using that second bottle of that glue, I don't like it. So I'm pretty sure the next one I'm going to buy is going to have the brush applicator, and we're going to see what that does. Until I started doing this, I don't believe I'd ever used an entire bottle of super glue. Now I go through 2 a month probably. Super glue is kind of one of those things you buy it, you use it one time for something, it dries up, throw it away. Not me. I go through several bottles. And I might try something different after this. If you got an idea or you know somebody that ties jigs, or if you're watching and you tie jigs and you got something better to use, send me a message. Let me know. I know a lot of people use head cement. I have a hard time getting a hold of that stuff. His tail down just a little bit. Make the two on the outside short and the two on the inside just a little bit longer. pretty cool jig. Nice. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Next ones I'm going to tie up. I'm not even sure what I'm going to do with them yet. But they are going to be... No, let's do... Let's do this. A couple of black ones. Let's see if I can't find everything here real quick. Some yellow Chanel. Not seen it. Alright, we're gonna do this one in black. So what I'm gonna do is start out with yellow hackle feathers and black feathers. We're going to use black thread because we got a black head and we're going to do a black body. I like the way this chick turns out. I can't find my... I see it. We're in luck. Alright, so that is the body, just like I do on all of them. And we are going to put in one yellow feather. And we're going to put in... one black one, and I figure I find the one I want. I got it. So I got one black hackle feather. Got them both just a little bit too long. I tied this one up a couple weeks ago. When I got done with it, I was like, man, this is a cool looking jig. And actually, I got an order for some going to Kentucky. So we're going to do that black and yellow hackle feather. And since I got some yellow in there, we're going to do some yellow flash. So let's see what we get here. Loop it in the middle, cut it in half. Thank you. There we go. I want that flash on that side of it. Not the side it was wanting to. Not the side it was wanting to fall on. So we're gonna do some yellow. Sometimes you get, you know, there's all kinds of different types of chenille. And when I tie something up that's small, I'm probably going to use a lot more thread in it to help build that body up. But this shit comes out pretty cool. I was going to name it, probably be the bumblebee. We're going to do two of these like this. Let's do one more at your head. Get it on the other side of your thread. Pull it up and push it down against that head. Right down in there. Let that kind of follow the contour of that ball head and let that thread just kind of roll in there. Right there. Give it a whip finish. Kind of tight. That's what we end up with. Can't really see that black hackle feather in there. Let me get it out. Let's see what we got. Yeah. That's a cool jig. All right, that's all I got for tonight. Keep yourself coronavirus free. Be careful, be safe, wash your hands. You got any, leave me a comment, message. But like, subscribe, hit that bell. I got a couple orange ones on the top. I might do another one later tonight. Like I said, there's nothing else to do at 2:06 in the morning. So like I said, like, share, subscribe, hit that bell. See ya.